Mr. President, without dreams, our life would become like a ship sailing aimlessly without any direction. Without dreams, our life would be chasing an unseen shadow without any meaning whatsoever. So being human, we all dream. While some experience dreams full of horror, tragedy and suspense, and some dreams inspire the generations, change the course of history. For a century, freedom was a dream for the Muslims of the subcontinent. Do you remember that era of tyranny and brutality and fear? But the Muslims fought for their freedom and stood victorious on 14th of August 1947 under the visionary leadership of Qaid Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah and Allama Muhammad Iqbal. Mr. President, our country was a true representation of dreams of our great ancestors. But what happened next? This was not the dream of Qaid Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah. We didn't work hard to protect our freedom. We didn't realize as a nation that we are the victim of corruption at all levels. While corruption has been acknowledged at national level, but our moral and ethical corruption is not being acknowledged. We haven't realized the fact that we have damaged our souls, not following the rules of traffic, throwing trash on roads, killing in the name of honor, killing in the name of faith. We have lost Amjad Farid Sabri. We have lost Mashal Khan. And that story behind the fame or defame of renowned scientist or proud Dr. Abdul Salam is yet another story. But despite of all these tragedies, Mr. President, our youth is still a ray of hope. The unsung hero, Mr. Ehtezaz Hassan Shaheed, who stopped a suicide bomber from killing more than 2,000 students, and their daughter of the nation, our tigress, Malala Yousafzai, who stared into the eyes of death when she was just 11 years old. They are the true spirit of our nation. And what about Arfa Kareem, the youngest Microsoft professional? Are proud. So let's have a dream that one day there will be a mosque, a church, a mandir and jamaatkhana in the same place without any fear and conflict. Let's have a dreams that we will live in a place where our differences are celebrated. My dear audience, I have a dream that my any child or your child, the child of Pakistan, will never be abused on streets and they will not be forced to beg. I have a dream that our children will live to sing the songs of peace, the hymns of peace. And please do not despair, my nation. Please light the candles and hinder the flames of your desire. Pakistan Zindabad.
Mr. Bilawal Ali Khan from International Islamic University, Islamabad.